I'm advancing to the Patrick Division Finals. I don't see many hands out there, but they have done it. Game 6 at the Coliseum versus the Capitals. The Islanders came back from a 1-0 deficit. They tied it. Then, while shorthanded, Benoit Hogue scores, gave the Islanders the lead that they would not give up. Just before the second period came to an end, Brad Delgarno scored his first playoff goal. 3-1 Islanders after 2. Then in the third, the icing on the cake and the controversy. Pierre Turgeon watched the cheap shot. Dale Hunter puts on Turgeon after the goal. Both Turgeon and then Benoit Hogue were injured from the rough stuff. While the Rangers and Devils are still getting tee times, though, the Islanders have ice time. 5-3 winners. They take the series 4-2 despite the cheap shot.
We don't want to dwell on what happened with Dale Hunter because we have a major task in beating the Penguins.
So they do move on. After 2, now 4-1, an ugly incident. Pierre Turgeon, the goal off a Dale Hunter giveaway. Then he became Headhunter instead of Dale Hunter, tried to maim Turgeon. No place for that in any sport. Throw the book at him. Too bad the series ended on that note. Islanders win 5-3. Sal Marciano sampled some reaction at the Coliseum about that cheap shot.
I'm disgusted at the play. I think that I've lost a tremendous amount of respect for that organization and that player, and there's no time in the league for a player like that, especially against a guy with as much heart and a player like Turgeon, who adds as much to the game as he does. And to hit a man when he's unaware at 3 seconds after he scored a goal is Bush League, and I hope the NHL clamps down on a guy like that.
I mean, they're talking about cleaning up the game. I think the punishment has to be severe in this case. I don't know what Mr. Bateman has planned, but I hope he looks at it very seriously. I mean, Pierre Turgeon is ranked with the Lemieux and the superstars of the game.
Absolutely. Game 1 Sunday in Pittsburgh, and Montreal also eliminated Quebec in 6-2.
Two of the playoffs as they beat the Caps at the Coliseum tonight. Second period, watch the shorthanded effort by Benoit Hogue as Kelly Johansson almost tackles him. Hogue somehow shug it past Beaupre to make it 2-1 Islanders. Great shot. Seconds before the end of the period, it was Brad Delgarno who scores off the rebound to give the Isles a 3-1 advantage. Then with a 4-1 in the third, Pierre Turgeon put the icing on the playoff cake with another goal. Capital Dale Hunter added one last tasteless act, hammering Turgeon after the goal. Result was predictable as a fight ensued. Most important result, the scoreboard. Isles will take on the Penguins for the division championship in round 2. One other NHL game tonight.
Don't like it, but like it. Again, Dennis Martinez, to be effective, has to pitch inside, even against left-handers. He tries to sneak that ball inside and have it run over.
Since 1987, when they needed 7 games to dispose of the Caps, now 6 years later, the Isles could accomplish the same feat in 6 games. 3 of the previous 5 games between these two have required overtime. And the Caps were in trouble. The Isles up 4-1. Pierre Turgeon in the third period makes them pay. Dale Hunter follows with a cheap shot. Turgeon out 4 to 6 weeks with a separated shoulder and a concussion.
There's a perfect example. The league says they want to clean up the game. Well, Mr. Bettman's got his first chance to clean it up because Hunter's been doing it for a lot of years. He's a cheap player, and he went and he took out one of the game's stars. And to suspend him at the start of next year does us no good. He's got to be hitting the pocketbook, and he's got to be hit hard because that's ridiculous.
Unless the Isles make it to the finals, Pierre Turgeon's season pretty much over. Separated shoulder, the concussion. Commissioner Bettman was at the game, will make a ruling on Thursday. The Canadians try to push the Nords into the offseason. Ron Hextall looking for redemption after a poor showing in Game 5. Paul DiPietro sneaking up right wing and a tough angle. DiPietro's second goal of the game and 3-2 halves. It's 4-2 Montreal. DiPietro all alone and give him the hat trick. DiPietro brought to his knees. Late in the third, 5-2 halves, DiPietro says, I've done enough scoring. How about Gilbert Dion? And then he puts that saber back into his pants. Pierre Pagé saying, What happened? What hit us? Montreal wins it 6-2. DiPietro with the hat trick and the assist. The Habs, 10th straight winning year that they've won the first round series after losing the first two, Montreal reeling off.
Won a playoff series since 1987.
HL. He made no secret of his desire to clean up the sport. Bettman got his chance when Washington's Dale Hunter used his stick as a weapon against New York Islander Pierre Turgeon during Wednesday night's playoff game. Less than 24 hours later, Bettman suspended Dale Hunter indefinitely. The length of the ban to be determined at the end of the week. Turgeon, the Islanders' leading scorer, had just put the finishing touch on what turned out to be a series-clinching victory for the Isles. Turgeon about to celebrate when Hunter, watch him, mugs him. If it happened on the street, Hunter could be arrested for assault and battery. Turgeon suffered a concussion and a separated shoulder.
It looked severe as it was taking place live, and it looked severe when I looked at it again on tape.
When we have all the factors in, we'll put a fixed time on the indefinite suspension. One of the factors we need to obviously take into account is the extent of the injury, and we need to see the medical reports to do that.
Now, Turgeon will miss the Islanders' second-round series against the Pittsburgh Penguins. By the way, Turgeon's agent is looking into taking Hunter's act of goonery to court. He's considering filing a civil damage claim.